Today's Mailbag Monday starts with the traditional pouring of the beer. This is Queen's Best Bitter, a malt base of nut and stone fruits balanced with an equally strong hop character of earthy and floral tones. This is not a style that I've had before, but I was reminded of it when Howard from Dubious Engineering brewed up a batch of it recently on his channel. So I figured I'd seek one out and give it a try. This particular one is from One Great City Brewing right here in Winnipeg. Well, that's all right. I'm not usually into the heavy herbal and floral styles, but that one's not overwhelming. That's pretty darn tasty. The malt's coming through nice. I like it. Now, I don't know how close to a legitimate best bitter from England that is. I'll have to travel someday and see, but in the meantime, I'm pretty pleased with that. So, my first item for the mailbag, it says it is plastic sheet. One of the traditional lies. Let's see what it really is. It is plastic. It is... Oh, this is some battery holders, some 2032 battery holders. I got some recently, but in a different shape. Let me just grab a battery here. So the other one that I got, they sit flat. This one plugs into the board that way, and battery goes in like that. I got, it looks like, 10 or so of them. So that'll be handy. I've got a couple of different options for powering little battery-powered projects. Cool. 10 pieces, CR2032, 2032, 3-volt cell coin battery, socket holder case, ROHS M40. Got this one from GC Supermarket, and I did, in fact, pay $1.37. And clearly, when I bought it, it did ship to Canada with free shipping. Doesn't say much about it other than exactly the title again. Okay, fair enough. All right, next in we have 2x plastic sheet. Well, let's see what that one is. Nothing in there. Oh, it is 2x. That's a good start. They're even stapled together. Okay. They are... What are they? Looks like a relay. Some header pins, a relay. Ah, these are a relay shield for a D1 Mini. Yeah, so they just go... Which way? That way around. Those headers stack on, and the D1 Minis tend to come with female headers. They come with male headers as well, but they also come with female headers. They just stack on like that, and there would be another set on the other side, obviously. Ta-da! Okay. So it looks like the resistor going to the base of this little transistor comes off D1. It's got a little star beside it. That seems reasonable enough. There's a diode across the coil backwards to prevent that inductive spike from blowing up the rest of your circuit. That's nice. And on the relay end here, it's got a couple of nice little anti-tracking slots. So there is the two contacts. Huh. So that one goes to... Yeah, it does. Okay. So there's the normally open and normally closed contacts, and there is the wiper or moving contact, common, whatever you want to call it. Cool. 2 pieces, 12-volt, one-channel relay shield V2 version 2 for WEMOS D1 Mini ESP8266 model Arduino. I got these ones from Top Electronic 1980 at auction, and for the two of them I paid $1.73 with free shipping. They don't sell them anymore. I will link you to this search, which will bring up a whole bunch of them, including some that are at auction right now. But it seems that you can get them for about $3-ish and up. Just checking a random eBay seller here. There's not that much information about them, other than some close-up pictures. They take 5 volts and... Yeah, not much that we didn't already know. Yeah, I could get used to that one. It's not nearly as herbal as your typical Belgian. It's got a nice dark malt. I like it. Next in, we have module and a whole bunch of numbers. Doesn't tell me very much at all. Ah, bunch of seven segment LED modules. Actually, they're just not even modules. They're just straight up seven segment LEDs. Okay. Oh yeah, I know. When I was tinkering away with that DIY guitar tuner that I was making, that I was working on months ago, I realized that I had precious few of these and not many that worked properly, so figured I'd grab a few more. So let's see what these are. Are they common anode or common cathode? That doesn't do anything. There we go. So these are common anode and the usual kind of pinout that you'd expect. The center pin is common on both the top and the bottom, and then the segments are on the other eight pins, seven segments plus the decimal point. Okay, let's see if I can find the listing for these. Seven segment, 0.56, 1.8, 0.36, 0.5 inch, 134 digit common cathode slash anode LED display. I got this one from Sense Smart. When I bought it, it was $1.37 in free shipping. And again, I'm not even going to comment on that. So they've got a whole bunch of different ones in this listing, but the ones that I bought were the half inch red seven segment LED times 10 pieces. And here is the description: 1.8 volt forward DC voltage, which is what you'd expect for red LEDs, between 15 and 20 milliamps. Sure, red and common anode. Package includes 10 pieces. Yeah. I ordered several different variants on the seven segment LED at the same time. So presumably the other ones are going to show up sometime in the next few weeks, I would hope. Now this guy came from the States. I ordered it from a company called QuickKicksLaptopKeys.com in Pennsylvania. And it is, in fact, well, it's supposed to be a laptop repair parts for my daughter's laptop. So let's see what we've got in. Wow. Okay, hang on. Okay, so there is the actual key for the laptop. And the little bits of mounting hardware. Hang on. So what we have in here is the key itself, the K, which is the one that she managed to break somehow. Maybe there's a game that uses K over and over again. There's a little hingy piece here. And there's a little rubber bumper thing. Okay, I assume that's the sort of gives you the spring back. Uh-oh, back up there. Okay, I'm hoping that there's some instructions on their website. So here's what I ordered. This will be specific to the laptop that I'm looking at, but this is probably pretty typical. But it was $3.99 for the one key plus shipping, which I can't remember what it was, but whatever. They've got a pretty good search on here, and it allowed me to find it pretty well. One thing I noted, there's for this model of laptop, there's two different types of hinge depending on which key you're getting, I guess. Maybe some of these other ones have different hinges on them. Not sure, but I took a magnifying glass to my daughter's laptop, and I'm 99% sure this is the one that I want. And they've got a pretty good little photo detail thing showing which hinge you need, and this is the one that I got, and I'm hoping that I'm correct. Oh, and they've even got some instructions. Nice. I shall be using that, I'm sure. Well, I hope I can make my little girl very happy here.
And the last thing in
is something that one of you guys sent me to my post office box. So this is a complete mystery. I don't know who sent it. I don't know what it is. Aha! That is an ESP-266, if I'm not mistaken. It is, in fact, an ESP-8266, a bare module, which is exactly the module that's in here behind the counter. Oh, yeah, I got the counter working again. Thanks to Brian Locke for rebuilding his library to work around whatever weirdness YouTube did. Worked first try. Anyway, so that's the same ESP-266 as is in there. Let me just yoink this guy out of its little packaging here. So in the back, you can see all the GPIO pins, and there is the labeling for the ones on this end. Now, this isn't breadboard-friendly pinout. These little, what are they called, castellated connections on the side here, these are designed for soldering straight down onto another board. So normally, you see ESP-266 chips deployed on a board like those ones there. D1 Mini, full-size D1, Lowin, whatever those, Node MCU. And you can see that the little castellated pins are soldered straight down. But the way I did the counter back there is on one of these little backer boards or breakout boards. So you solder it down just like that. You treat it basically like a surface mount component. Solder it down, and then it breaks it out to breadboard-friendly pins, which is pretty slick. And these things are super cheap. I'm pretty sure I've got some more on order. One thing about these, the ESP-266s are 3.3-volt chip. This one's got a footprint for a specific regulator on the back, so you can run it off 5 volts and it'll just drop it down. One thing I've been warned about is that this pin out here is, as I said, for a specific regulator and may not match every type of 3-tab linear voltage regulator. So if I'm going to use it in that mode, I'll have to be a little bit careful and just make sure what I've got is correct. Thank you to whoever you are that sent me this little ESP-266 module. That'll come in handy. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Another wide, wide assortment, as typically happens around here. So, transit times. The 7-segment LEDs took 17 days. The CR2032 battery holders took 9.5 weeks. These two D1 Mini Relay shields took 55 days. The laptop keys took 14 days from the States, which is pretty good. And this little guy, I have no idea how long it took because I don't know who sent it or when they sent it, but I sure do appreciate having it. Well, that was fun as always, and a nice little beer to try. I hadn't tried that kind before. So thanks, Howard, for putting that in my mind. And thank you all for watching. Thank you to my Patreon supporters for helping support me in my endeavors to keep you amused and entertained and possibly informed without going broke doing it. I really appreciate the help that those guys give. Thanks to the viewers. Thanks especially to whoever this was. Comments and questions down in the comments section as usual. You know the drill. Cheers. I'll talk to you later.